A dolphin is an aquatic mammal within the infraorder Cetacea. Dolphin species belong to the families Delphinidae, the oceanic dolphins, Platanistidae, the Indian River dolphins, Iniidae, the New World River dolphins, Pontoporiidae, the brackish dolphins, and the extinct Lipitidae Beiji or Chinese River dolphin. There are 40 extant species named as dolphins. Dolphins range in size from the 1.7 meter. Long 5'7" and 50 kg 110-pound Maui's dolphin to the 9.5 meters 31'2" and 10-ton 11-shore-ton orca. Several species of dolphins exhibit sexual dimorphism, in that the males are larger than females. They have streamlined bodies and two limbs that are modified into flippers. Though not quite as flexible as seals, some dolphins can briefly travel at speeds of 29 kilometers 18 miles per hour or leap about 30 feet 9.1 m. Dolphins use their conical teeth to capture fast-moving prey. They have well-developed hearing, which is adapted for both air and water. It is so well-developed that some can survive even if they are blind. Some species are well-adapted for diving to great depths. They have a layer of fat, or blubber, under the skin to keep warm in the cold water. Dolphins are widespread. Most species prefer the warm waters of the tropic zones, but some, like the right whale dolphin, prefer colder climates. Dolphins feed largely on fish and squid, but a few, like the orca, feed on large mammals such as seals. Male dolphins typically mate with multiple females every year, but females only mate every 2 to 3 years. Calves are typically born in the spring and summer months, and females bear all the responsibility for raising them. Mothers of some species fast and nurse their young for a relatively long period of time. Dolphins produce a variety of vocalizations, usually in the form of clicks and whistles. Dolphins are sometimes hunted in places such as Japan, in an activity known as dolphin drive hunting. Besides drive hunting, they also face threats from bycatch, habitat loss, and marine pollution. Dolphins have been depicted in various cultures worldwide. Dolphins occasionally feature in literature and film, as in the film series Free Willy. Dolphins are sometimes kept in captivity and trained to perform tricks. The most common dolphin species in captivity is the bottlenose dolphin, while there are around 60 orcas in captivity. The name is originally from Greek delta epsilon lambda phi delphis, dolphin, which was related to the Greek delta epsilon lambda phi delphius, womb. The animal's name can therefore be interpreted as meaning a fish with a womb. The name was transmitted via the Latin Delphinus, the romanization of the later Greek Delta Epsilon Lambda Phi Nu Omicron Delphinos, which in medieval Latin became Dolphinus, and in Old French Dolphin, which reintroduced the ph into the word dolphin. The term mere swine, that is, sea pig, has also historically been used. The term dolphin can be used to refer to most species in the family Delphinidae, oceanic dolphins, and the river dolphin families Iniidae, South American river dolphins, Pontoporiidae La Plata dolphin, Lipitidae Yangtze River dolphin, and Platanistidae Ganges River dolphin and Indus River dolphin. This term has often been applied in the US, mainly in the fishing industry, to all small cetaceans. Dolphins and porpoises are considered porpoises, while the fish dorado is called dolphin fish. In common usage, the term whale is used only for the larger cetacean species, while the smaller ones with a beaked or longer nose are considered dolphins. The name dolphin is used casually as a synonym for bottlenose dolphin, the most common and familiar species of dolphin. There are 6 species of dolphins commonly thought of as whales, collectively known as blackfish: the orca, the melon-headed whale, the pygmy killer whale, the false killer whale, and the 2 species of pilot whales, all of which are classified under the family Delphinidae and qualify as dolphins. Although the terms dolphin and porpoise are sometimes used interchangeably, porpoises usually refers to the Phocoenidae family, which have a shorter beak and spade-shaped teeth and differ in their behavior. A group of dolphins is called a school or a pod. Male dolphins are called bulls, females called cows, and young dolphins are called calves. In 1933, 3 hybrid dolphins beached off the Irish coast. They were hybrids between rissos and bottlenose dolphins. This mating was later repeated in captivity, producing a hybrid calf. In captivity, a bottlenose and a rough-toothed dolphin produced hybrid offspring. A common bottlenose hybrid lives at SeaWorld California. Other dolphin hybrids live in captivity around the world or have been reported in the wild, such as a bottlenose Atlantic spotted hybrid. The best-known hybrid is the wolfin, a false killer whale bottlenose dolphin hybrid. The wolfin is a fertile hybrid. Two wolfins currently live at the Sea Life Park in Hawaii. The first was born in 1985 from a male false killer whale and a female bottlenose. Wolfins have also been observed in the wild. Dolphins are descendants of land-dwelling mammals of the artiodactyl order, even-toed ungulates. They are related to the Indohyas, an extinct chevrotain-like ungulate, from which they split approximately 48 million years ago. The primitive cetaceans, or archaeocetes, first took to the sea approximately 49 million years ago and became fully aquatic by 5 to 10 million years later. Archaeocete is a parvater comprising ancient whales. These ancient whales are the predecessors of modern whales, stretching back to their first ancestor that spent their lives near rarely in the water. Likewise, the archaeocetes can be anywhere from near fully terrestrial, to semi-aquatic to fully aquatic, but what defines an archaeocete is the presence of visible legs or asymmetrical teeth. Their features became adapted for living in the marine environment. Major anatomical changes include the hearing set, up that channeled vibrations from the jaw to the ear bone, which occurred with Ambulocetus 49 million years ago, a streamlining of the body and the growth of flukes on the tail, which occurred around 43 million years ago with Protocetus, the migration of the nasal openings toward the top of the cranium and the modification of the forelimbs into flippers, which occurred with Basilosaurus 35 million years ago, and the shrinking and eventual disappearance of the hind limbs, which took place with the first odontocetes and mysticetes 34 million years ago. The modern dolphin skeleton has two small, rod-shaped pelvic bones thought to be vestigial hind limbs. In October 2006, an unusual bottlenose dolphin was captured in Japan. It had small fins on each side of its genital slit, which scientists believe to be an unusually pronounced development of these vestigial hind limbs. Today, the closest living relatives of cetaceans are the hippopotamuses. These share a semi-aquatic ancestor that branched off from other artiodactyls some 60 million years ago. Around 40 million years ago, a common ancestor between the two branched off into cetacea and anthracotheres. Anthracotheres became extinct at the end of the Pleistocene 2.5 million years ago, eventually leaving only one surviving lineage, the two species of hippo. Dolphins have torpedo-shaped bodies with generally non-flexible necks, limbs modified into flippers, a tail fin, and bulbous heads. Dolphin skulls have small eye orbits, long snouts, and eyes placed on the sides of its head. They lack external ear flaps. Dolphins range in size from the 1.7 m 5 feet 7 in long and 50 kilograms 110 pounds Maui's dolphin to the 9.5 m 31 feet 2 in and 10 t 11 short tons orca. Overall, they tend to be dwarfed by other cetartiodactyls. Several species have female-biased sexual dimorphism, with the females being larger than the males. Dolphins have conical teeth, as opposed to porpoises' spade-shaped teeth. These conical teeth are used to catch swift prey such as fish, squid, or large mammals, such as seal. Breathing involves expelling stale air from their blowhole, in an upward blast, which may be visible in cold air, followed by inhaling fresh air into the lungs. Dolphins have rather small, unidentifiable spouts. All dolphins have a thick layer of blubber, thickness varying on climate. This blubber can help with buoyancy, protection to some extent, as predators would have a hard time getting through a thick layer of fat, and energy for leaner times. The primary usage for blubber is insulation from the harsh climate. Calves, generally, are born with a thin layer of blubber, which develops at different paces depending on the habitat. Dolphins have a two-chambered stomach that is similar in structure to terrestrial carnivores. They have fundic and pyloric chambers. Dolphins' reproductive organs are located inside the body, with genital slits on the ventral belly side. Males have two slits, one concealing the penis and one further behind for the anus. Females have one genital slit, housing the vagina and the anus, with a mammary slit on either side. The integumentary system is an organ system mostly consisted of skin, hair, nails, and endocrine glands. The skin of dolphins is very important as it is specialized to satisfy specific requirements. Some of these requirements include protection, fat storage, heat regulation, and sensory perception. The skin of a dolphin is made up of two parts, the epidermis and the blubber, which consists of two layers including the dermis and subcutis. The dolphin's skin is known to have a smooth rubber texture and is without hair and glands, except mammary glands. At birth, A newborn dolphin has hairs lined up in a single band on both sides of the rostrum, which is their jaw, and usually have a total length of 16 to 17 centimeters. Dolphins are a part of the species Cetacea. The epidermis of this species is characterized by the lack of keratin and by a prominent intertwine of epidermal reedy pegs and long dermal papillae. The epidermal reedy pegs are the epithelial extensions that project into the underlying connective tissue in both skin and mucous membranes. The dermal papillae are finger-like projections that help adhesion between the epidermal and dermal layers, as well as providing a larger surface area to nourish the epidermal layer. The thickness of a dolphin's epidermis differs, depending on species and age. The integumentary system is an organ system mostly consisted of skin, hair, nails, and endocrine glands. The skin of dolphins is very important as it is specialized to satisfy specific requirements. Some of these requirements include protection, fat storage, heat regulation, and sensory perception. The skin of a dolphin is made up of two parts, the epidermis and the blubber, which consists of two layers including the dermis and subcutis. The dolphin's skin is known to have a smooth rubber texture and is without hair and glands, except mammary glands. At birth, a newborn dolphin has hairs lined up in a single band on both sides of the rostrum, which is their jaw, and usually have a total length of 16 to 17 centimeters. Dolphins are a part of the species Cetacea. The epidermis of this species is characterized by the lack of keratin and by a prominent intertwine of epidermal reedy pegs and long dermal papillae. The epidermal reedy pegs are the epithelial extensions that project into the underlying connective tissue in both skin and mucous membranes. The dermal papillae are finger-like projections that help adhesion between the epidermal and dermal layers, as well as providing a larger surface area to nourish the epidermal layer. The thickness of a dolphin's epidermis differs, depending on species and age. Blubber is found within the dermis and subcutis layer. The dermis blends gradually with the adipose layer, which is known as fat, because the fat may extend up to the epidermis border and collagen fiber bundles extend throughout the whole subcutaneous blubber, which is fat found under the skin. The thickness of the subcutaneous blubber or fat depends on the dolphin's health, development, location, reproductive state, and how well it feeds. This fat is thickest on the dolphin's back and belly. Most of the dolphin's body fat is accumulated in a thick layer of blubber. Blubber differs from fat in that, in addition to fat cells, it contains a fibrous network of connective tissue. The blubber functions to streamline the body and to form specialized locomotor structures such as the dorsal fin, propulsive fluke blades, and caudal keels. There are many nerve endings that resemble small, onion-like configurations that are present in the superficial portion of the dermis. Mechanoreceptors are found within the interlocks of the epidermis with dermal ridges. There are nerve fibers in the dermis that extend to the epidermis. These nerve endings are known to be highly proprioceptive, which explains sensory perception. Proprioception, which is also known as kinesthesia, is the body's ability to sense its location, movements, and actions. Dolphins are sensitive to vibrations and small pressure changes. Blood vessels and nerve endings can be found within the dermis. There is a plexus of parallel running arteries and veins in the dorsal fin, fluke, and flippers. The blubber manipulates the blood vessels to help the dolphin stay warm. When the temperature drops, the blubber constricts the blood vessels to reduce blood flow in the dolphin. This allows the dolphin to spend less energy heating its own body, ultimately keeping the animal warmer without burning energy as quick. In order to release heat, the heat must pass the blubber layer. There are thermal windows that lack blubber, are not fully insulated, and are somewhat thin and highly vascularized, including the dorsal fin, flukes, and flippers. These thermal windows are a good way for dolphins to get rid of excess heat if overheating. Additionally, in order to conserve heat, dolphins use countercurrent heat exchange. Blood flows in different directions in order for heat to transfer across membranes. Heat from warm blood leaving the heart will heat up the cold blood that is headed back to the heart from the extremities, meaning that the heart always has warm blood, and it decreases the heat lost to the water in those thermal windows. Dolphins have two pectoral flippers, containing four digits, a boneless dorsal fin for stability, and a tail fin for propulsion. Although dolphins do not possess external hind limbs, some possess discrete rudimentary appendages, which may contain feet and digits. Dolphins are fast swimmers in comparison to Seals, which typically cruise at 9 to 28 kilometers h 5.6 to 17.4 miles per hour, the orca, in comparison, can travel at speeds up to 55.5 kilometers h 34.5 miles per hour. The fusing of the neck vertebrae, while increasing stability when swimming at high speeds, decreases flexibility, which means they are unable to turn their heads. River dolphins have non-fused neck vertebrae and can turn their heads up to 90. Dolphins swim by moving their tail fin and rear body vertically, while their flippers are mainly used for steering. Some species log out of the water, which may allow them to travel faster. Their skeletal anatomy allows them to be fast swimmers. All species have a dorsal fin to prevent themselves from involuntarily spinning in the water. Some dolphins are adapted for diving to great depths. In addition to their streamlined bodies, some can selectively slow their heart rate to conserve oxygen. Some can also reroute blood from tissue tolerant of water pressure to the heart, brain, and other organs. Their hemoglobin and myoglobin store oxygen in body tissues, and they have twice the concentration of myoglobin than hemoglobin. The dolphin ear has specific adaptations to the marine environment. In humans, the middle ear works as an impedance equalizer between the outside air's low impedance and the cochlear fluid's high impedance. In dolphins, and other marine mammals, there is no great difference between the outer and inner environments. Instead of sound passing through the outer ear to the middle ear, dolphins receive sound through the throat, from which it passes through a low impedance fat-filled cavity to the inner ear. The dolphin ear is acoustically isolated from the skull by air-filled sinus pockets, which allow for greater directional hearing underwater. Dolphins send out high-frequency clicks from an organ known as a melon. This melon consists of fat, and the skull of any such creature containing a melon will have a large depression. This allows dolphins to produce biosonar for orientation. Though most dolphins do not have hair, they do have hair follicles that may perform some sensory function. Beyond locating an object, echolocation also provides the animal with an idea on an object's shape and size, though how exactly this works is not yet understood. The small hairs on the rostrum of the vado are believed to function as a tactile sense, possibly to compensate for the vado's poor eyesight. The dolphin eye is relatively small for its size, yet they do retain a good degree of eyesight. As well as this, the eyes of a dolphin are placed on the sides of its head, so their vision consists of two fields, rather than a binocular view like humans have. When dolphins surface, their lens and cornea correct the nearsightedness that results from the refraction of light. They contain both rod and cone cells, meaning they can see in both dim and bright light, but they have far more rod cells than they do cone cells. They lack short wavelength sensitive visual pigments in their cone cells, indicating a more limited capacity for color vision than most mammals. Most dolphins have slightly flattened eyeballs, enlarged pupils which shrink as they surface to prevent damage, slightly flattened corneas, and a tapetum lucidum. These adaptations allow for large amounts of light to pass through the eye and, therefore, a very clear image of the surrounding area. They also have glands on the eyelids and outer corneal layer that act as protection for the cornea. The olfactory lobes and nerve are absent in dolphins, suggesting that they have no sense of smell. Dolphins are not thought to have a good sense of taste, as their taste buds are atrophied or missing altogether. Some have preferences for different kinds of fish, indicating some taste. Dolphins are known to teach, learn, cooperate, scheme, and grieve. The neocortex of many species is home to elongated spindle neurons that, prior to 2007, were known only in hominids. In humans, these cells are involved in social conduct, emotions, judgment, and theory of mind. Cetacean spindle neurons are found in areas of the brain that are homologous to where they are found in humans, suggesting that they perform a similar function. Brain size was previously considered a major indicator of the intelligence of an animal. Since most of the brain is used for maintaining bodily functions, greater ratios of brain to body mass may increase the amount of brain mass available for more complex cognitive tasks. Allometric analysis indicates that mammalian brain size scales at approximately the 2/3 or 3/4 exponent of the body mass. Comparison of a particular animal's brain size with the expected brain size based on such allometric analysis provides an encephalization quotient that can be used as another indication of animal intelligence. Orcas have the second largest brain mass of any animal on Earth, next to the sperm whale. The brain-to-body mass ratio in some is second only to humans. Self-awareness is seen, by some, to be a sign of highly developed, abstract thinking. Self-awareness, though not well defined scientifically, is believed to be the precursor to more advanced processes like metacognitive reasoning, thinking about thinking, that are typical of humans. Research in this field has suggested that cetaceans, among others, possess self-awareness. The most widely used test for self-awareness in animals is the mirror test, in which a mirror is introduced to an animal, and the animal is then marked with a temporary dye. If the animal then goes to the mirror in order to view the mark, it has exhibited strong evidence of self-awareness. Some disagree with these findings, arguing that the results of these tests are open to human interpretation and susceptible to the Clever-Hans effect. This test is much less definitive than when used for primates, because primates can touch the mark or the mirror, while cetaceans cannot, making their alleged self-recognition behavior less certain. Skeptics argue that behaviors that are said to identify self-awareness resemble existing social behaviors, and so researchers could be misinterpreting self-awareness for social responses to another individual. The researchers counter-argue that the behaviors shown are evidence of self-awareness, as they are very different from normal responses to another individual. Whereas apes can merely touch the mark on themselves with their fingers, cetaceans show less definitive behavior of self-awareness. They can only twist and turn themselves to observe the mark. In 1995, Martin and Sirakos used television to test dolphin self-awareness. They showed dolphins real-time footage of themselves, recorded footage, and another dolphin. They concluded that their evidence suggested self-awareness rather than social behavior. While this particular study has not been repeated since then, dolphins have since passed the mirror test. Some researchers have argued that evidence for self-awareness has not been convincingly demonstrated. Dolphins are highly social animals, often living in pods of up to a dozen individuals, though pod sizes and structures vary greatly between species and locations. In places with a high abundance of food, pods can merge temporarily, forming a superpod. Such groupings may exceed 1,000 dolphins. Membership in pods is not rigid, interchange is common. They establish strong social bonds, and will stay with injured or ill members, helping them to breathe by bringing them to the surface if needed. This altruism does not appear to be limited to their own species. The dolphin moko in New Zealand has been observed guiding a female pygmy sperm whale together with her calf out of shallow water where they had stranded several times. They have also been seen protecting swimmers from sharks by swimming circles around the swimmers or charging the sharks to make them go away. Dolphins communicate using a variety of clicks, whistle-like sounds, and other vocalizations. Dolphins also use nonverbal communication by means of touch and posturing. Dolphins also display culture, something long believed to be unique to humans and possibly other primate species. In May 2005, a discovery in Australia found Indo-Pacific bottlenose dolphins tergiops aduncus teaching their young to use tools. They cover their snouts with sponges to protect them while foraging. This knowledge is mostly transferred by mothers to daughters, unlike simian primates, where knowledge is generally passed on to both sexes. Using sponges as mouth protection is a learned behavior. Another learned behavior was discovered among river dolphins in Brazil, where some male dolphins use weeds and sticks as part of a sexual display. Forms of caregiving between fellows and even for members of different species see moko dolphin are recorded in various species, such as trying to save weakened fellows or female pilot whales holding up dead calves for long periods. Dolphins engage in acts of aggression towards each other. The older a male dolphin is, the more likely his body is to be covered with bite scars. Male dolphins can get into disputes over companions and females. Acts of aggression can become so intense that targeted dolphins sometimes go into exile after losing a fight. Male bottlenose dolphins have been known to engage in infanticide. Dolphins have also been known to kill porpoises for reasons which are not fully understood, as porpoises generally do not share the same diet as dolphins and are therefore not competitors for food supplies. The Cornwall Wildlife Trust